WYFF News 4, live local breaking news at 6.
Good evening, I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And I'm Michael Cogdill. We're going to begin on this Friday night with a day the NASCAR world will never forget. It was 10 years ago today that legend Dale Earnhardt lost his life in the final turn of the Daytona 500.
For some people who were there that day, the memory is fresh and it is powerful. News 4 sports director Jeff Hart joins us now with a news story from a tragedy now 10 years old. Jeff?
Well, the 2001 Daytona 500 will always be remembered because of the death of Dale Earnhardt, a terrible accident that still haunts the driver lucky enough to win the race and unlucky to forever be tied to the tragedy that day at Daytona. Mark Dover has the story.
The Sunsplash Track at Daytona. Stock car racing's greatest cathedral.
20 years of trying, 20 years of frustration. Dale Earnhardt will come to the caution flag to win the Daytona 500.
The site of this sport's greatest victories.
And listen to this.
A constant reminder of NASCAR's darkest day.
I don't like that. That's the kind of crash that hurts you.
It's hard to believe. It doesn't feel like it's been that long, but it has. 10 years goes by pretty fast.
It's a day that you really want to forget, but you can't forget it because it's part of, especially I can't forget it because it's such a big part of my life.
You got it!
You got it!
My game!
February 18th, 2001, the greatest day of Michael Waltrip's life. It's also the worst day of his life.
This is undoubtedly one of the toughest announcements that I've ever personally had to make. But after the accident in turn 4 at the end of the Daytona 500,